Good evening. We welcome you to St. Joseph-St, Pius X Parish to worship together. I have a few announcements. If there is anyone at your home or that you may know who would like to receive communion, please contact the parish office. The rest of the Holy Week schedule is as follows. There will be Stations of the Cross tomorrow at 3 p.m. at St. Pius X Church. Good Friday services will be at 7 o'clock here at St. Pius. The Easter Vigil will be at 7 p.m. also here, and Easter Sunday, April 4th, will be at 9 a.m. also here. Please join us on Saturday, April 10th, from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. for our grand opening of our new-to-you thrift shop furniture annex. Bring your family and friends to receive a free gift and a chance to win a beautiful spring wreath. The Partners in Charity appeal is now in full swing. Thank you for those who have sent their pledge or their gift in, and for those who have not yet made a gift or a pledge, please consider helping us reach our parish goal while helping those less fortunate in our diocese. Today's Mass is offered for the people of St. Joseph's St. Pius X Parish. Our organ is Denise Sullivan with the choir, and Morgan Fledman and I, Rocky DeRoshu, will be your lectors. Please rise.
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God our Father, and the fellowship of God the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Tonight is a powerful night of remembrance and a celebration of freedom. We remember God's radical action on behalf of the ancient Israelites and Jesus' radical action on our behalf. The Passover of the Israelites and the Last Supper of Jesus and the disciples were not only remembrances, but also calls to action. They empowered those who ate to do something more. Our sharing in tonight's Eucharistic meal is our commitment to live and act as people who have been freed to follow Jesus' example of humbly serving others. So let us take a moment to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, to pause and recall our sin and ask God's pardon and his grace.
Lord Jesus, you are the light that dispels the darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are the way to eternal life. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are here to lead us to the promised land. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, as he was about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the Church a sacrifice new for all eternity. Grant that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of love and life. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one, and shall share in the lamb, in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month, and then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it, with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand. You shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on the same night I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt, I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, also, the cup, after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this, as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes." The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So, during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today, on this Holy Thursday, of course, we celebrate the institution of the Eucharist, as we say, and what we listen to in listening and preparing to celebrate that institution is we listen to the first reading, which is a reading from the book of Exodus about the Passover and the preparation of the Passover lamb and how a lamb was chosen without blemish and was to be consumed by the family that night. And if your family wasn't big enough to consume a whole lamb, then you would come together with another family or with two other families in order to be able to consume that whole lamb that night. And it was to be sacrificed. It was a sacrifice, an offering to God in thanksgiving. And then they were to take the blood of that lamb, and they were to sprinkle it on their door, on the lintels of their door. And by doing that, what was going to occur was that the angel of death would pass over their house. And so the Jews call this the Feast of Passover. But it is the feast also which made them Jewish in many ways. It is the feast that every Jew must celebrate, must remember. And when they talk about that, they do it every year in remembrance of that day, of that first Passover. And as they listen to the story of the Passover at their Seder meal, as they ask the questions, and as they read the prayers and the readings and sing the songs, what they are doing is they are going through that Passover themselves. They are being with the people of Israel as they leave the slavery in Egypt and go out into the desert to the Promised Land. So their remembrance is not just a recalling of, but it is a reenactment of it in many ways. It is remembering themselves with that first group of members of the people, of the chosen people. And they are remembering themselves. When we come together to celebrate the Eucharist, we're told by St. Paul in several writings of his, we're told to do this in remembrance of me. That Jesus says, do this in remembrance of me. He tells us that in the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, and Luke as well. To do this in remembrance of me. That we are called again to remember ourselves with those first disciples. And as we go through these 3 days of the Triduum, what happens? Well, tonight, usually we would wash some of your feet, or I'd wash your hands as a symbolic action of what Jesus did, to replace, to put ourselves again back in that place where the disciples were that night, to remember ourselves with the disciples. And then tomorrow, what we'll do is we'll read the Passion. And we, the crowd, we are the crowd, and we read, crucify him, crucify him. We are reminded of how Peter said he would never deny the Lord, how he would never deny him. He would go to his death with him. And 3 times Peter denies even knowing him. And we are there with the centurions whipping him. We are there with the ones who abandoned him, the disciples who abandoned him. And we watch as this Jesus goes to his death, alone, except for a couple, his mother, and a couple of friends of hers and his, and one disciple. We are reminding ourselves that Jesus, and especially in the Gospel of John, Jesus is very intentional in his ministry and his work. Everything he does has a meaning. He goes to the cross basically alone, but he doesn't do it just for himself or just because of anything he did. He does it for his disciples who abandoned him. He does it for those people who yelled, "Crucify him." He does it for the centurions who nail him onto that cross. He does it for Pilate and for all of us. And we remember ourselves with those people. We remember ourselves in the mystery of who Jesus is, of that great saving mission of his, that he would die for my sins, for what I hadn't even been born, but yet he did it for my sins. And I must remember that I was there on that day too, when he died for me, because in my baptism, I share in the body of Christ. And so each of us, over the course of these next 3 days, are asked to remember ourselves in the body of Christ and in the mystery that we celebrate, this great saving mystery of Jesus going to his death, his laying in the tomb, and the wondrous resurrection that occurs on Sunday. And as we do this, it's a journey. It's a 3-day journey. And we're asked to take it one step at a time. Tonight, we're reminded that Jesus dies for us each and every time at the Eucharist. He dies with us each and every time at the Eucharist. And that we're called, because of that sacrifice, to go out and to serve in his name in the world. To be willing to lower ourselves to servant status in order that the world might become more like God's kingdom. And that's where I'll leave you tonight.
We pray for the church on earth, that we may be guided to a greater understanding of the perfect love and service of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in positions of power and influence in the world, that they may understand something of the spirit of Christ's sacrifice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are confronted by temptation, that they may be strengthened by Christ's example of loyalty to his Father, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us in this community, that more and more we may reflect in our lives of the Eucharistic love of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that in this time of isolation, we will continue to be generous to others with our time and support the needs of the hungry with food donations and our parish with our envelopes and online giving. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who have died. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the intentions listed in our parish book of intentions and for those that we hold in the silence of our hearts. For these intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O Father, we come before you and present our needs to you, humbled by the Eucharistic love and generosity of your Son, our eternal priest, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Pray now, my sisters and brothers, that this our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of God.
For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord. Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true eternal priest, who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice, and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial, as we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong, and as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Gracious. your whole family, which we make to you as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer for us, for our salvation and the salvation of all that is today, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing. Broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Oops, already did that. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing. In giving the chalice to his disciples, he said, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus,
Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beg you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory of yours shall
be forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and grant her the peace and unity of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us pray for peace among each other and throughout the entire world.
Thank you. Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son of this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet for all ages to come, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Usually at this time of the service, we would have the transfer of the Eucharist, but because we can't have processions during the COVID time, we won't be able to do that. But what we're going to do tonight, and at the end of this service, there's no final blessing, because these services go one to the other to the other. So they don't end until the resurrection. So there will be no final blessing, but we will sing Tom to Mergo, and we'll incense the tabernacle. If you would like to stay for a while, pray with the precious blood and body, please feel free to do so. And they'll be singing Tom to Mergo, a couple of verses of Tom to Mergo. And then we ask that you leave in silence, okay?